Several months ago, I made the commitment to make short reviews of things that I didn't really necessarily feel like I had a whole lot to say on, but I didn't really want to do batch reviews of novels because they're usually so thematically different that they don't really fit together. So I decided that I would just review books anyway, regardless of how much I had to say about them, and just do shorter reviews. So I made one of those and then never did it again. But I am returning to this and hopefully will continue this trend on into 2015. And today I want to talk about The Elegance of the Hedgehog by Muriel Barbery. I just don't feel like I have a whole lot to say, but I did want to speak about this book because, first of all, I think I have things to say about it that I haven't heard said before, and secondly, it's not a book that's really widely spoken of on BookTube. So, The Elegance of the Hedgehog is a dual narrative. The first perspective is of the concierge of this big house, and then the second perspective is of a young girl who lives in the house. The concierge, she's a middle-aged woman, she is a widow and is pretty dissatisfied with life. A lot of her chapters are highly philosophical and are also usually her judging the people that live in the building. And then the girl's perspective is quite similar, honestly, quite philosophical, and she has decided that she is going to set the house on fire and then kill herself, but first she wants to write down all of her brilliant thoughts into this diary. They're both quite judgmental of the people that live in the building. They're both quite interested in Japanese aesthetic, Japanese culture, particularly ancient Japanese culture, and they're also quite interested in philosophy. So while they're two distinctly different people, coming from different backgrounds, different ages, they both think and write quite similarly, which I don't think was to the book's advantage. I really wish that there was more of a contrast between the two because they didn't really interact with one another, but they both had very similar ideas, and it was weird how similar these two people were, and I don't know if that was intended or if that was a flaw of the writing, but it was odd. I also didn't love the philosophy. I found myself much more enjoying the plot-based elements, which is very strange for me because I don't mind philosophy. I don't mind more character-driven works. I don't mind slow-paced books, but for some reason I found the philosophy just made this book feel like so much more of a slog, and I wanted to skim or skip the philosophical parts. I tried to read them, but they made the book, they slowed the book down so much and made it much more dense, and I just didn't find myself really enjoying it that much, and I don't know what is wrong with me or wrong with the book, because I thought we would get along much better. Because the characters are so similar, I don't think the dual narrative really added much, which is really honestly too bad, because I am quite drawn to dual narratives. One of my favorite books of all time, A Tale for the Time Being, is a dual narrative. I just don't know if it was that successfully executed in this, and this is a book that was written in originally French, so it might come across better in the original language, who knows. I picked this up though because I thought I would really like it, and I really wanted to read something that was originally written in French or from France, because it's not a country that I think I've ever read a book from before. And I remember someone on BookTube saying that they really enjoyed it. It sounded like something that would appeal to me, but it just didn't. And I don't know if it was just I read it at the wrong time or it just wasn't for me, but didn't hate it. I don't want to sound like I hated it. I thought it was just okay. Very middle of the road. Liked it a lot better after about halfway through. The first half seemed extremely slow, like glacially slow, and then once the actual plot kind of kicked up, I was really enjoying it and thought it was interesting, and the characters started to develop and change. But then I also hated the ending, so I don't know, I thought the ending was totally out of left field, completely unnecessary. It didn't really make sense in the context of what had happened throughout the rest of the book. It was just so dissatisfying. I'm not really usually put off by weird or dissatisfying endings, but this one just rubbed me the wrong way, and all in all, I give this book kind of a shrug. So those are my thoughts on The Elegance of the Hedgehog. I wish that I had nicer things to say about it, but I didn't hate it. So if any of those things sounded appealing to you, I encourage you to check it out. These books, the Europa editions of books are really beautiful. They have really beautiful spines, and they also have French flaps that are quite nice. I hope you guys enjoyed my review, or at least found it interesting or something, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!